Hello, good morning. In the previous class, we are starting equation are the expression for the gravitational potential and the gravitational field intensity due to solid spherical shell. We already studied case 1 and case 2, and we are continuing here case 3. In that case 3, we had calculated two types of equation, that is case 3 at a point P inside the shell, and in that case we have already calculated the potential at P due to the inner solid sphere, that is V1 is equals to minus 4 by 3 pi r square rho g. Here g is the gravitational constant, rho is the density of the material, okay, r is the radius, okay, radius of the circle, here 4 by 3. Potential at P due to the shell of radius small r and capital R will be here the V2 is equals to minus twice pi rho capital G capital R square minus small r square. So this is the second number of potential. Okay, so in this class we are continuing this equation, that is the total potential at a point P due to the solid spherical shell for the case 3, where the point P situated inside the shell is, therefore The total potential at point P is, that is capital V is equals to V1 plus V2. Okay, and we have the values of V1 and V2, that is V1 is equals to minus 4 by 3 pi r square rho capital G plus here the sign minus and here minus, because potential always has negative sign, minus twice pi rho G capital R square minus small r square. Okay, so we are putting the value of V1 and value of V2. So from these two terms we are taking common. Okay, here pi is the common between two words. Here capital G is the common, rho is the common. Okay, and here 1 by 3. So in that term we get total minus twice pi, okay, rho and G as the common term, minus twice pi rho G, and the remaining term, okay, remaining term means plus 2 by 3 here r square. Okay, here the minus take common, so for that we write here plus in bracket r square minus small r square. So this is the balancing term in the bracket, 2 by 3 small r square plus r square minus. Okay, so if we are removing this bracket, we get minus twice pi rho g 2 by 3 small r square plus capital R square minus R square. Okay, and here small r square and small r square term take each side. Okay, the remaining expression, that is V is equals to, we get minus twice pi rho g, okay, and the smaller term taking near about, that is 2 by 3 small r square minus small r square plus capital R square. Okay, so this 2 by 3 r square minus small r square, we get the term after calculation, we are taking LCM. LCM of these two, V is equals to minus twice pi rho g, and LCM of this term, that is the 2 by 3 small r square minus r square. Here we are taking LCM as a 3, and here twice r square for the first term, and secondly 3 r square. Okay, so the 2 r square minus 3 r square, here is the 1 r square means r square by 3. Okay, so we get the term, that is 1 by 3 r square minus 1 by 3 r square in minus, okay, plus capital R square. So then after calculating this term, we get here v is equals to minus twice pi rho g minus 1 by 3 small r square plus capital R square. Okay, so therefore v is equals to, this is the minus term, we get in the next term, that is minus twice pi rho g capital R square, we write first time, and minus 1 by 3 small r square. Okay, because this is a minus term and plus term, we interchanging term, small r square minus 1 by 3 r square. So if we are taking here LCM again, so we get the term, this multiplied by 3 minus twice pi rho g 3 r square minus capital R square divided by 3. Okay, 3 capital R square minus small r square divided by 3. Then again this 1 by 3 taking outside this bracket, we get minus 2 by 3 pi rho g and in the bracket 3 r square minus small r square. Okay, so this is the value of v. And here adjusting term means multiplied both the term, means multiplied both side, that is numerator and denominator, by twice r cube. Multiplying and dividing by twice r cube. Okay, twice r cube. So after multiplying, we get v is equals to minus 2 by 3 pi rho g and multiplied by twice r cube. And dividing term we write here in the bracket, 3 r square minus small r square divided by twice r cube. Okay, so by solving this 2 into 2, we get the 4, okay, and this r cube. So we write here minus 4 by 3 pi r cube rho and g. Okay, 4 by 3 pi r cube rho and g, and in the bracket 3 r square minus small r square divided by twice r cube. Okay, so we have the term here 4 by 3 pi r cube rho g. This is nothing but the mass, capital M. So put this value, total value as M. Therefore V is equals to minus M. We write here M, and here G is outside the, okay. So this is the minus G M. This term is the minus G M. And remaining term, that is 3 r square minus small r square divided by twice r cube. Since 4 by 3 pi r capital R cube and rho is equals to m. Okay. So finally we get the value of v, that is minus gm, this term is the m and this is the constant g, we get minus gm and bracket term as usual, 3 r square minus small r square divided by twice r cube. So this is the total potential at point P, and where the point P situated inside the solid sphere, for the case third, at a point P inside the shell. So this is the total potential at point P is V is equals to minus Gm in bracket 3 r square minus small r square divided by twice r cube. Okay, so this is the gravitational potential. Then next one is the gravitational field intensity. So second is the gravitational field intensity. Gravitational field intensity. Okay. So we know that gravitational field intensity E is equals to minus dV by dr. We know that E is equals to minus dV by dr. Therefore, E is equals to minus d by dr of V, and value of V is minus gm 3 capital R square minus small r square divided by twice r cube. Okay, so for the derivative this is the small r, and for that there is a simple r derivative. So constant term we are taking outside the derivative, that is E is equals to minus gm. Okay, and remaining term, that is gm, and this is the constant, and it is twice r cube, and only d by dr of 3 r square minus small r square. Okay, only derivative are the 3 r square minus small r square. Then again E is equals to minus gm divided by twice r cube, and this d by dr of 3 r square becomes 0, and d by dr of minus r square. Okay, derivative of r square is the twice r, and this is the minus sign, that is minus twice r. Okay, so therefore E is equals to this 2 and 2 cancelled, and we get E is equals to minus gm by r cube, and minus minus plus we get small r. So this is the gravitational field intensity. Sorry, one word here, the sign minus and this minus. Minus of V means here plus, and this is the minus twice R, here the sign minus. E is equals to minus gm small r divided by R cube. So this is the gravitational field intensity at a point P inside the shell. Okay, so in the next class, so thus from this equation, thus the intensity of gravitational field at a point P inside the sphere is directly proportional to the distance, means this r directly proportional to the distance of the point P from the center of the sphere. This r is the distance of point P from the center, so therefore this E is directly proportional to the distance where the point P is situated. Okay, E is directly proportional to r. So in the next class we calculated the remaining part of this equation, that is the gravitational force, that is F is equals to m into E. Thank you.